delta difference, small but finite. Problem solving, an elegant approach. A motorboat going downstream in a river overcame a raft at a point A. T equals 60 minutes later, it turned back and after some time passed the raft at a distance L equals 6 kilometers from the point A. Find the flow velocity, assuming the velocity of boat with respect to water remains constant. The problem looks familiar, isn't it? Yes, it's the very first problem in the famous book I.E. Iredov. In physics, when you do problems in a conventional way, sometimes they look a little lengthier. But physics offers you such nice tricks. Of course, even the tricks are from the first principles, using which you can always make a solution look simple, ingenious. Let us try this problem and see how we can make it look neat. First, we will try the conventional solution and then go for the elegant one. But for that, you need to wait till the last. As usual, we need to visualize and picture the problem. There's a river and water is flowing in the river with a certain velocity there, which is not given in the problem. It's not a pond, waters are moving. So that is unknown velocity here for us. And if you look at the problem, even the boat's velocity with respect to water is not given. What it says is, it's going downstream. Let us assume that this is the direction of flow of water. I'll call this velocity VW. I'm showing the vector separately, so I'm showing the speed here. Or if you want, you can put as well an arrow over there. Vector. Now, there's a boat which is passing the raft at some point A. I'll put this point as A, and a boat we have. Looking like a boat, all right. That's enough. This boat is actually going that side. Let me take it out. This boat is going that side. Alright. This boat is meeting a raft. Raft is simple plank basically, nothing else. A plank I'll put here. This plank is just drifting on the water, on the surface of water. It should be going with the same speed as the water. It's floating down the stream. Now boat met the raft here. And boat, of course, will have a velocity that is V of boat with respect to water plus V of water. Of course, remember, all the statements are made by a person standing here on the banks. He is looking at the boat to go with V of boat with respect to water plus V of water. What is the basic there? Velocity with respect to ground frame of an object is equal to velocity relative to the moving frame plus velocity of the moving frame. Here, velocity of moving frame is velocity of water. Velocity relative is the velocity of the boat with respect to water. So it goes like that. So this person says, yes, this boat is moving faster than the raft. So this boat is going somewhere here, for example. Until here it went. Alright. And then it went 60 minutes later, it turned back. That means this distance, this time it took is 60 minutes, which is actually 1 hour. Therefore, the distance covered from here to here, we could write immediately. We may require it. So I'll write it as V of boat with respect to water plus V of water into 1 hour is this distance. Now here, the boat turns back. All right, the boat is turning back. From here the boat turns, all right, and as the boat is turned back, of course the raft was still going downstream along with water. Now somewhere here the boat comes where it is meeting the raft again. Okay, there's no place for raft. I'll put it put the raft here, all right, and then the boat here. Okay, let me know, just to say it's a boat. There's a boat here. Now this boat came back, so it took 1 hour to go downstream, then came back. But while coming back, the velocity of the boat with respect to him on the ground will be v of boat with respect to water minus v of water. It should be velocity relative minus this one. If the boat has no if the boat has a lesser velocity than water, it cannot go upstream. Therefore v of boat with respect to water minus v of water is velocity of boat while coming back with respect to a person standing on the shore. And this time is unknown. Let us say this time is some t. So if you do the problem in a normal way, you will try to do it. And what he says is this distance is 6 kilometers from A. This is all the data given in the question. Look, the boat is going downstream with this speed with respect to ground. It traveled for 1 hour, then it turned back. All this time the raft was floating. Now this boat is meeting the raft at a distance of 6 kilometers from the starting point A. So just the picture itself tells you what to do. But remember, now this fellow is writing all the equations. We'll write, see, automatically this distance, whatever distance this 60 minutes, therefore this is the distance is v of boat with respect to water plus v of water into 1. This distance minus this distance should be equal to 6 is 1, information we have. So I'll write like that, v of boat with respect to water plus v of water into 1 hour, all right, minus v of boat with respect to water minus v of water into this travel for a time t here. T is equal to 6 kilometers. Look, all this calculation algebra is written from the perspective of a person standing on the shore. Now, but he also sees the raft to flow down like that. For how much time totally? 1 hour for the boat to go there and T hours to come back. All this time, the raft was simply floating down. So for the flat, plank, if you write the equation, for the raft, if I write the equation with respect to his perspective, it will be simply going floating down with the velocity of water. So V water into 1 plus T is also equal to 6 kilometers. So the whole thing reduces to solving this equation. We'll solve it, actually speaking. So V of boat with respect to water into 1 plus V water minus V boat with respect to water into T plus V water into T is 6 kilometers, right? So here V of boat with respect to water, this is there here. I'll write it separately, plus V of water into 1 plus T, this together is becoming like this, is equal to 6 kilometers. And we already know this is 6 kilometers. So this 6 and this 6 cancel out. And somewhere else I'm missing something here. What is this? This is V into T. Into T is here, right? Yes. So now V of boat with respect to water is equal to V of boat with respect to water into T. So this cancelling, you will get simply T equals 1 hour. That means that extra time it took after turning back to meet the raft is 1 hour you got. Now just put this 1 hour somewhere here, for example, you will get VW into 1 plus 1 is equal to 6. So VW equals simply 3 kilometer per hour we got. So this is all right. This nice, visually everything was clear, and it took a little time to do the algebra, but all right, we have got the answer. But sometimes problems can be done much more quicker way, and as well an elegant way, as I told you. Even that will be the requirement of the exams as well, isn't it? So in physics, there are certain things like, say, applying conservation of energy, conservation of angular momentum, or in general, let me say, conservation laws makes the problem solving easier. Or sometimes switching the reference frames makes it easier. Like this, for almost every lesson, there are few things like that where the problem solving can be made simple. Here, we'll use the idea of switching the reference frames. When I said switching the reference frames, first in this ground reference frame, we'll write the equation for the raft. From ground reference frame, this fellow is writing the equation for the raft, which is very simple actually. Where did we write it? Actually, here. That is V of water into T plus 1 is equal to 6 kilometers. I think we followed it because the raft was after all covering that 1 meter downstream and T also downstream. So simply we are writing this. Now let us just go to the raft's frame and see. When I see from the raft's frame, because it is floating down, drifting down along with water, a person standing on that and looking at waters will feel that waters are at rest, or it looks like a pond for him. So he sees a boat going and coming back to him, nothing else. Boat goes downstream and comes back and meets him. And look, it goes for 1 hour down. And it came for 2 hours back. And for him, waters are not moving. So this boat will be moving. Say, I'll put the stream on raft here. Person stands. The boat is going like that for 1 hour. As if it is moving on a pond, as if it is moving on a ground, just like that, and then comes back for tea and meets the person again. All this time, this person was not in the knowledge of motion at all. So if it takes 1 hour to go back, go away from the raft, to come back, it should take 1 hour again because waters are not moving. But here, of course, this velocity of the boat will be velocity of boat with respect to water. Another funny thing in this problem we have seen, the answers are becoming independent of this velocity of boat with respect to water. Even here, we don't require it. I am using this to tell you that a person standing here will see the boat to go with this velocity, not V of boat with respect to water plus V water as felt by this fellow. But he simply says, this boat has got a velocity relative to water so much, it goes there for 1 hour. And to meet him, it should take 1 more hour to meet him, isn't it? Because it is like moving on a still surface. So T equals 1 hour, we could get just at one go. Isn't it so? So this T equals 1 hour, we can put here and get our answer back again. So all this calculation now becomes redundant. This is what you mean by doing a problem in a smart way.